80% of the patients who have Kawasaki disease are under 5 years of age. So occasionally it is seen in older children and adolescents, and even occasionally in adults. But the majority of patients are children, and especially young children. These children then will be followed by a pediatric cardiologist, even if they're initially treated for the Kawasaki disease, and they get their gamma globulin infusion, which is done in hospital overnight, usually, and they get their aspirin by mouth. After that, after their first ultrasound of the heart or echocardiogram is done, they will go home on low-dose aspirin once a day. And then a few weeks later, they'll come back and see the pediatric heart specialist again, the pediatric cardiologist. They'll do another echocardiogram or ultrasound of the heart and look to see if there's any complications that have been left behind. Generally, they'll have a third echocardiogram about 6 to 8 weeks out from the initial illness. And if that echocardiogram at that time is normal, then the aspirin will be stopped and they'll be discharged from further follow-up. If that echocardiogram at 6 to 8 weeks shows the complications in the heart that Kawasaki can cause, the aneurysms in the coronary arteries, the arteries that supply blood to the heart, then those children would stay on aspirin for a year and continue to be followed by the cardiologist, the pediatric cardiologist. The good news is that at the end of that year, the majority of patients who had coronary aneurysms at the beginning of that year will no longer have them at the end of the year. So that is the good news, that in the majority of patients, even if it does have the complication of coronary artery aneurysms, they will go away after that first year.